Now, that important element, as you can see here, is now the first term also involves numbers. So now we've covered every example out there. Does the pattern still hold? Yes and no. For example, if we multiply these numbers, does it come out to that number? Again, with these numbers, will it come out to this number? Will the multiplication pattern still hold here? Please take a moment to check. All right, great. It still holds, and that's wonderful. However, the addition pattern no longer holds, as you can see here. Negative 2 plus negative 5 is not negative 16. Now, why does the pattern no longer hold all of a sudden? And that's because of the numbers that are involved in the first term of each binomial. Because if you look at FOIL, there are two terms that are added together. So I'm going to take one example here, namely this example. So if I look at 2x plus 2 times 3x minus 9, this is going to give me 6x squared, negative 18x, plus 6x, negative 18. Notice what I do here. From this step, I have to combine the like terms. So you'll notice that negative 18 still only involves these two numbers, no other number. But the middle term now, and here I'm going to highlight in blue, middle term involves the combination of these two numbers, and usually we just added. However, because we're multiplying these two numbers to get one of the terms, these two numbers to get one of the terms, namely this one, and these two numbers to get the other term, we have to take into consideration all four terms. So that's the main difference here. And with that, I'm going to introduce the last step to the crisscross method. So let's do out this example, shall we? Just like how you looked at factors of 24, so for example, 1, 24, 2, 12, 3, 4, 3, 8, and 4, 6, you also have to look at factors of the first term as well. So if we look at 6x squared, what are its factors? You could have 1x times 6x, but you could also have 2x times 3x. And so in order to try out all of these possibilities, you have to try the same thing out twice now. Now you'll notice here I didn't put any negatives because the term is going to be positive. And so what multiplies into positive as well as add to positive? Well, the numbers have to both be positive. So I'm not going to do a negative here, but we'll soon see that in the next example. So it's called the crisscross method because we are multiplying this way. And what I'm now looking to see are the two pairs that give me the middle sum. So what do I mean by that? So if I do 6x times 1, I will get 6x. 1x times 24, I get 24x. If I add them up, do I get the term that I wanted right here? No, I don't. So you know this pattern does not work, or this pair doesn't work. And we're going to repeat this process, so let's do it for the second pair. 6x times 2 is 12x. 1x times 12 is 12x, and we get 24x. Not quite. And here we have 6x times 3, which is 18x, plus 1x times 8, which is 8x, and this works. So if this works, we don't have to try out any of the other pairs because we found the one that we want to use. Now, when we write the answer, this is going to be the last key part of crisscross method. When we write the answer, we're going to write across. Now, I know 1x was multiplied to 8 and not 3, but when we write the answer, we're going to write x plus 3. And we're going to write 6x plus 8. And the reason behind that is because when we looked at the FOIL example, you'll have noticed that the two numbers involved, again going back to here, negative 18x and 6x, they came from the pairing, one from this left binomial and the other number from the right binomial. So I did not multiply 2x times 2 to get negative 18. In fact, I multiplied 2x times negative 9. Likewise, I multiplied positive 2 times 3x to get 6x. So I did not multiply the numbers next to each other. So if I go back here, I multiplied x with 8x to get 8x, and 3 times 6x to get 18x in order to get the sum 26x that I wanted. So in order to actually do this out in the manner that FOIL helps us, I have to make sure that the numbers are not written out together. So when you multiply, again, you're using a crisscross, so an x. But when you write the answer, you're going to write across. All right, let's do out just two more examples to ground out this crisscross method.